brothers.
Welcome to Championship Wrestling here at ringside. This is Vince McMahon along with wrestling great Pat Patterson, where this week we'll take another look at the brothers Jules and Jay the Strongbow.
Well, Vince, they're doing very, very good as a team. It's a new team. Now, I don't know if they're really ready for the championship, but so far they look very good.
Scheduled to join us as well, a man that would make almost two of any ordinary wrestlers, making reference to the 6'9", 330-plus pounds of Black Jack Mulligan.
Well, Vince, you remember what happened a few weeks ago? Someone's going to have to stop that big man. There's no questions about it. He is strong. He is powerful. He doesn't care about the rules. Someone's going to have to stop him.
And the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, wrestler extraordinaire, here with us.
Without a doubt, he's one of a kind. He's a man that utilizes the rope. He's all over the ring, and he's truly a great athlete. And, Vince, I'd like to say one thing. I really like your jacket.
Thank you, Pat. Scheduled as well that Jonas will be the likes of Mr. USA, Tony Atlas, and in our feature confrontation, Greg Valentine, tested by Tony Garea. Those matches and more when we return in a moment. Wrestling will appear in Madison Square Garden on Saturday night, June 5. Ladies and gentlemen, Ivan Putski and Pedro Morales meeting individual competition of Mr. Fuji and Mr. Saito, respectively. On the special Saturday night card of wrestling in Madison Square Garden on the 5th of June as well, we shall see the tag team combination of Brothers Jules and Jay the Strongbow squared off against the East-West tag team connection of Adrian Adonis and Jesse the Body Ventura. No doubt a tremendous test for the Strongbow brothers. Aside from that, many of you will recall and indeed saw what happened recently when Andre the Giant was in a match and Black Jack Mulligan decided to interfere. Well, as a result of that interference, they show clash in Madison Square Garden to find out once and for all who is the better man, Mulligan or Andre. And of course, waiting in the wings to defend the World Wrestling Federation title will be the champion, Bob Backlund, as he meets the man who defeated him recently in Madison Square Garden, the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka. Here now with us to discuss this title defense is the champion, Bob Backlund. And Bob, first of all, you've had many things happen to you during your reign as champion, some 4 years now. It has not always been an easy reign, to say the least, but would you please recount to the fans what was going on in your mind after the initial appearance of you and Superfly Snuka, when Mr. Snuka leaped from the top rope, crushing your ribs, and for the first time in your career, you were carried from the ring on a stretcher. I wonder if you would recount what was on your mind at that time.
Well, Vince, when I got out, when I was laying there, I didn't dare take a deep breath because those ribs were pushing into my lungs so hard, and I just wouldn't dare expand them because there was so much pain. But when I got laid on that stretcher and they were carrying me out, I started fighting it because I didn't want to be embarrassed or be shamed by carrying out a stretcher. And there was a strap around my ribs right here, and I broke that strap and tried to get out of there. But the one around my legs, I couldn't break, and I couldn't get out of there. And when I started doing it, I started breathing heavy, and the ribs started pushing in towards that lung, and it caused a lot of pain. And I let him carry me out because I knew the match was over, and I knew he'd done the damage and got out of there, and there was nothing more I could do. But by golly, right now there's three things that are very important to me. One is my family, one is this belt, and one is all those people out there. And when I get into that ring, I'm not going to think about these two sore ribs that I have. I'm going to think about all you people out there. I'm going to think about this belt, and I'm going to think about my family at home worrying about me when I'm wrestling against Jimmy Snuka, wherever it is. I want to get this man. I want to cause him some pain. I want to do a little damage to him like he did to me and hurt him, like he's hurting my family. Because when I leave home to wrestle you, Snuka, my family's going to be crying. My little girl's going to be crying. And I may be crying too, worrying about...
Discretionary viewer participation is advised for the following pro wrestling exhibition.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, this
is Championship Wrestling, promoted by Phil Zacco, supervised by the State Athletic Commission, the Honorable J.J. Binns, Chairman, Francis Walker is the Executive Secretary, and the officials assigned, Chief Deputy Commissioner in Charge, Tom Malandro, the Doctor in Attendance at Ringside, Dr. George Soharian, the Timekeeper at the Bell, Charlie Daniels, and the referees for this hour of wrestling, Dick Worley, Danny Davis, Billy Caputo, and my name is Jim McGill. All the opening contest, it is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Puerto Rico, weighing 231 pounds, it is Mac Rivera. And in the corner to my right, from Roanoke, Virginia, weighing 250 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, here is Mr. USA, Tony Atlas.
What an extraordinary physique. Tony Atlas locking up with Mac Rivera. Here we go.
Taking this commercial timeout, tomorrow night, a big card of professional wrestling is on its way to North Bergen, New Jersey at the Embassy Hall. Getting underway at 8 p.m. featuring Jesse the Body Ventura, featuring Adrian Adonis, featuring Ivan Putski. North Bergen, New Jersey, Embassy Hall, tomorrow night at 8 p.m. And then on Wednesday, May 19th in Middlesex, New Jersey at the Middlesex High School, none other than the Intercontinental Champion, Pedro Morales, will headline it all at Middlesex, New Jersey High School, May 19th.
The broadcast is being brought to you by the Authority of Capital Wrestling Corporation. We'd like to remind you that the use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of the telecast, including the imposition of a charge, without the express written consent of Capital Wrestling, is prohibited. Rivera obviously lacking as far as some experience is concerned compared to Tony Atlas.
Very true, Vince. It's really showing. And, of course, we all know that Tony Atlas is well experienced. And you know, Vince, the man can really wrestle. When he gets in the ring with competition, he can really put it out.
Well, look at our capacity crowd on hand as Atlas takes a shot on the forehead and apparently does not faze Mr. Atlas at all. Asking for a clean break and gets one, but for a moment you thought maybe Atlas was going to cut it loose.
Yeah, and for a moment I thought maybe Rivera would sucker punch Atlas. Sometimes you want to be a nice guy, but it fires back on you.
Well, Mac Rivera is being anything but a nice guy at the moment. Rivera with forearms, right hands, knees, everything. Hitting Tony Atlas. Atlas so heavily muscled that to strike him anywhere but on the head doesn't take all that much out of him. Atlas retaliating now. Double chop to the neck area. Down goes Mac Rivera.
I tell you, you have to do a lot of punching and kicking to wear Atlas down. He's really well trained and well conditioned.
Doubles his man up, does Tony Atlas. Atlas asking the referee to please move aside for a moment. Atlas and Mac Rivera with the same color tights on. On occasion, it's difficult to tell wrestlers apart Well, they have the same color tights. It's very easy here. The difference in the physique's extraordinary.
Of course, if you don't know who Tony Atlas is, you're in trouble.
Atlas getting an okay from the fans. And if this were anyone but Mac Rivera, I don't think he'd have an opportunity to ask the fans what they would want.
No way if you do that with an experienced wrestler in the ring.
But that is extraordinary. Unbelievable athlete, this Tony Atlas, as Rivera is hauled around like some sort of trophy. Dumped across the knee, Atlas took it easy on him, I think, and gets the three count. Tony Atlas with a very easy victory. And the fans like it when Atlas goes right up with his opponent. We'll get the official time, after which we'll take you to some slow motion.
It is time, 3 minutes and 58 seconds. The winner, Mr. USA, Tony Atlas.
Tony Atlas victorious, as we'll take a look now in slow motion. Rivera. Atlas goes underneath him and right up, just like he were a feather.
Vince, he's got to have good balance, a good back especially, to carry that kind of weight over your head like that.
Unbelievable athlete, this Tony Atlas. We'll go back up now for another match.
The next contest that is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing in at 232 pounds, it is Jeff Karani. And in the corner to my left, from the Fiji Islands, weighing 250 pounds, it is Jimmy Superfly Sanuka, with his manager, that fearless Captain Lou Albano.
The Superfly and all his regalia. There's a look at Jimmy Snuka. It is reported that Mr. Snuka can speak some English, although Mr. Albano has refused Mr. Snuka to speak.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me. I didn't know how Lou Albano is. He likes to talk. He talks more than he does anything else.
That is not a halo about the head of Lou Albano. Not a
Certainly
halo at
not.
All. Albano, the manager of the tag team champions, and boy, he's a manager of perhaps a championship-bound athlete here in the Superfly.
Well, there's no question, Vince, that Superfly has got to be a great athlete. You can tell by looking at him. He looks like an athlete, and he moves like one. He's really one of a kind.
Knee to the forehead, backing Craney down on his knee in the corner. Is yanked out now with a handful of hair. Snap there, over he goes. Snuka off the rope. Oh, my.
You'll see Snuka utilizing the rope quite a bit in the match. He's really all over the ring, from the top rope to the bottom rope, from one end of the ring to the other. If you want to keep up with Snuka, you got to be in great condition.
I don't know what this man trains on or with the Fiji Islands, but he is really put together. Stuck up. Off the rope, down across the forehead. And Craney is really paying some dues here this week.
There again, we saw Snuka utilizing the rope again, jumping up the second rope.
To the outside, and perhaps that's where he should be. Oh, no, wait a minute. Albano's out there.
Vince, this is totally disgusting. I think that when a manager does that in front of a referee, the man should be automatically disqualified.
Craney, a gallant young man now attempting to enter the ring, but Snuka apparently wants to keep him outside.
You know, I've seen Craney wrestle quite a few times, and he's coming up pretty good. He's been doing very well for himself, but he has no chance with Snuka, and of course, less chance with Albano at ringside.
Snuka now chancing disqualification as the referee backs him off. Again, chanting disqualification. Brings him in the hard way. Snuka. Whoa! Headbutt. Cover by the Superfly.
Vince, it's amazing to do the move that he does and moving around the ring the way he does barefooted. That is something really special. Not too many wrestlers can do that.
Very special athlete in Superfly Snuka.
Here is the time, 3 minutes and 30 seconds, and the winner, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Mr. Snuka continues his reign as far as being undefeated is concerned, Snuka and Albano's. Now we go to slow motion. Here now, Craney, who is pretty much out of it, a game young man, who, as you brought out, Pat, is coming into his own as a rookie, and Snuka pointing head first right down into Jeff Craney. Lights out for Craney, another victory for Snuka. We return with Tony Garea against Greg Valentine.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. But first, I'd like to introduce the manager. Here he is, the manager of champions, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. And in the corner to my right, from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 240 pounds, here is Tony Garea. And his opponent in the corner to my left, from Seattle, Washington, weighing 250 pounds, here is Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Mr. Valentine's talent's not really appreciated all that much, apparently, by this capacity crowd, as the Grand Wizard prepares Valentine to lock up with Tony Garea.
Pausing for this commercial break, in upcoming mat action, Wednesday, May 19th, this Wednesday, in Brewster, New York, at the Brewster High School, Tony Garea, Rick McGraw, Steve Travis, they'll all be in Brewster, New York, at the high school this Wednesday night. Thursday, May 20th, in East Brunswick, New Jersey, Big Black Jack Mulligan and Tony Atlas will be among those in East Brunswick, New Jersey, this Thursday night. And Friday, May 21st, in Middletown, New Jersey, at the Middletown North High School, we're going to see Pedro Morales, Swede Hansen, and more at the Middletown, New Jersey North High School this Friday, May 21st.
Subtlety a moment ago by Garea as the Wizard was exiting through the ropes. You see Garea snap the top rope.
Yes, I did. Very important match for both men, Vince. On television, both top men. This should be a great and exciting match.
Garea knowing full well that he's going to have to be as much of the aggressor as Valentine is if he's going to come out on top.
Well, if you remember the last time that Greg Valentine challenged someone on television, it was Pedro Morales, and we all remember what he did to Pedro Morales. So we'll have to watch very close to see what turns out into this match.
As I recall, there was a suplex. Morales was suplexed on the cement floor, was he not?
Exactly, and I'm sure that Tony Garea is very aware of that.
Oh! For a moment, I thought Garea was going to let Valentine have it. Garea hesitated, and that's all Greg Valentine needed.
Well, Tony Garea really trusted Valentine. He's a guy you can't trust.
Forbes in his own right. Valentine's backing up at Tony Garea. Oh, again, Valentine used the referee to his advantage. Garea with a reversal.
Very important match for Tony Garea, and I'm sure he would love to win this match.
And again, Garea inadvertently distracted by the referee. Valentine took control. Off the rope, Valentine setting the elbow. Boom! Garea with chops. Tony Garea with tremendous resiliency. Another chop to the throat. Valentine, a tough customer all the way.
Tony's got to continue. He's got Valentine in trouble right now, and he's got to continue and stay on top of him.
Garea winding up Valentine.
I tell you, one guy that's really worried is the Grand Wizard. He's really walking back and forth outside of the ring. Really, really concerned.
The Wizard looking on and objecting to what's going on in a moment. Off the rope. Scoop by Doom from behind. Up in the air. Greg Valentine, a comic knee drop.
That hurt. That really hurt.
Garea with a handful of hair. Tony Garea really pouring it on. Mr. Valentine winds him up and again works on the wrist area and elbow that he was working on earlier.
I really thought that after Tony Garea gave Valentine the atomic drop, he could have went for the pin. Maybe he felt he wasn't ready yet.
Drop toe hold a moment ago, executed perfectly. And now Valentine up to his old tricks. Valentine beginning to work on the legs.
Well, we all know what Valentine's going to be going for. If he has a chance, he'll go for the figure four leg lock.
Valentine softening up the legs of Garea, principally the left one. Trying to get him over, I believe, for a half crab. Garea's shoulder a moment ago on the canvas. Notice how Valentine is turning sideways to prevent Garea from kicking out.
And Tony has to be very careful, too, to make sure that the referee doesn't count down his shoulder. He has to pay attention to the count.
If Garea can get the right leg to the inside, he may be able to kick out of that, but no. Valentine applies more pressure. Oh, what an elbow that was. But Garea still suffering the effects of the leg attack earlier on, and once again, Valentine right back.
Well, I think that Valentine, when he does something, he does it well. Very aggressive.
With authority, as they say. Valentine working on all different angles of the left leg of Tony Garea. Switching off from pressure to the ankle, then to the knee, then to the calf. Over the hip. And again, this time, the right leg of Garea. Going for the figure four leg lock, I believe.
Now, I don't know why he's hesitating right there. I don't know why.
Step up and toe hold again. Garea's left leg is injured to the extent, apparently, that he can't even kick out with it. Now, Tony tugging on the wrist. spin over by Garea. Valentine stays right with him. No, on time. Again, Garea. Tony having his problems, but boy, is he ever a determined athlete. Using the one good leg he has left.
He's still really favoring that left leg.
Attacking the injured leg. Step over, toe hold. Trying for the figure four. Blizzard pleading with Valentine. Consoling him a bit. Shouting instructions to Valentine.
Well, it could be that if Valentine was to lose this match, that the Grand Wizard would fire him.
For Garea. Valentine takes him up and down right on his head. Right on his head. And a kick out by Garea. How in the world he did that?
Garea has got to be hurt. There's no question about it. Dropped him right on his head.
Small package, you got it. No. Wow. You talk about close.
That was a small package.
Give credit to Garea, though, the cagey veteran he is. He almost pulled it out. Slugfest developing now. Garea's punches shouldn't have all that much behind it, but he's using that one good leg. Caught him right in the chops. Big whirly shot by Garea. Whirly getting in the way. And Big Whirly's got a lot of guts to try and get it down between these two tigers.
He does.
Valentine is getting out of there, however.
These two men don't want to stop. They want to win, both of them. But there's got to be order in the ring. The referee did a very good job.
Well, at the official result here, it would appear as though the referee threw them both out.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, in 8 minutes and 42 seconds, the referee has disqualified both wrestlers, declares the bout a draw.
I tell you, I'd love to see this match go on myself. I'm really enjoying it. Great match.
Garea took an awful lot of punishment all the way through. What a gallant young man he is. And no doubt we'll be seeing more of the Grand Wizard and Valentine. But we'll be back as we continue with more. And Tony Garea would like to have a great deal more right now.
Andre the Giant, ladies and gentlemen, against Blackjack Mulligan the Giant. Mulligan claims he is the true giant. How do you respond to that, Andre the Giant?
I could be the true giant. He's only 6'9". But Blackjack Mulligan...
Yeah, let me interrupt you, however.
Yes, sir.
If I may. He would be the only true giant if he can defeat you because you... Thus far undefeated, you already know what it feels like to have the iron claw slapped on you, don't you?
Yeah, I know. I know what it is. And Blackjack Mulligan, I know you're a tough guy. I know the way you're wrestling. You do anything you want. But you never wrestling against a big guy before. That's why you don't know what it is to be a real giant. I'm going to show you what it is to be a real giant. And if you want to feel like a giant, after I get you in the ring, let me know if you still want to be a giant.
Next time you need an oil filter, a spark plugs, or anything for your car, you go to R&S or Strauss. They got it all. You need tires, battery, shocks, brakes, a muffler? Get this over to R&S or Strauss. They'll do something you may not have seen in a long time. A good job. Or do it yourself with our free guides. So at ease with the number one automotive stores, R&S in New Jersey, Strauss in New York.
To protect your car finish in all kinds of weather, get new, improved, super hard shell paste or liquid wax by Turtle Wax.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 225 pounds, it is George Rosello. And in the corner to my left, from Kansas City, weighing 248 pounds, it is Cowboy Bob Orton.
Bob Orton, along with his manager, Grand Wizard of Wrestling, is a busy man here this week. The Grand Wizard will have action in a moment.
The following is commercial in nature. We're getting closer to the date of Saturday, June 5th. We're getting closer to the Super Saturday Spectacular in Madison Square Garden, where we'll see on the card the Strongbow Brothers meet the East-West Connection, Adrian Adonis and Jesse the Body Ventura, where the Battle of the Titans takes place when Andre the Giant collides with Blackjack Mulligan, and we will find out if Bob Backlund is at 100% when he defends his title June 5th in the Garden in a return bout against Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Rosello obviously having his problems as anyone would against this man, Cowboy Bob Orton.
Well, I'll guarantee you, Rosello won't be able to do anything against Orton. Absolutely nothing. Vince, I have a lot of respect for Orton when it comes to his wrestling ability. We talked many times about different wrestlers having great amateur wrestling background. Well, Orton is one of them. He has a tremendous amateur wrestling background. He's one of the great wrestlers in wrestling today, believe me.
One of the few wrestlers that began wrestling as early as the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund. They both began at the age of 10. When did you begin wrestling, Pat?
I started professionally when I was 17 years old, Vince.
Rosello caught up all in between, all wrapped up and locked up in a rope. He doesn't know where to go, can't go anywhere. Rosello on a cement floor. And Orton, no, don't let him do it. Orton peering down on his opponent. Oh, right to the back.
I've said it so many times, Vince, he takes a lot of chance, that Orton.
What is he ever down to the knee? Throws literally his man back into the ring.
Orton is the kind of man that can really, really give you what you call a wrestling match. This man can really wrestle. And look at the things he does. He does it so well.
Does everything well. Uh-oh. I wonder, yes, here we go. A patented Bob Orton maneuver. Nobody does this. A superplex.
Very, very impressive, Vince. There's no question about it. And I doubt it very much if Rosello gets back in the ring for quite a long time.
Well, there was no match to begin with, and Orton knew that, of course, going into it. Didn't bother him at all. What's he complaining about?
I don't know.
Here is the time. 2 minutes and 53 seconds. The winner, Cowboy Bob Orton.
Bob Orton victorious as he embraces his manager, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. We'll go now to some slow motion that we saw, and this is the way Orton had Rosello in the corner. Rosello, like anyone else who finds himself in his predicament, you see Orton getting some leverage, bouncing off that rope, and my goodness, Pat Patterson, that has got to be one of the most devastating maneuvers in pro wrestling today.
It is, without a doubt. Even Orton, that kind of maneuver, Orton really takes some punishment to himself by coming down this way.
But not nearly as much as
not nearly as much as Rosello, believe me.
All righty, we shall return, ladies and gentlemen, with Blackjack Mulligan.
Jules and Jay, the strong ball brothers, Sweet Hansen, and a whole lot more.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, scheduled for one ball with a 10-minute time limit. But first, I want to introduce the manager. Here is that Hollywood fashion plate of wrestling, Kalassi, Freddie Balassi. And in the corner to my right, from West Palm Beach, Florida, weighing 221 pounds, it is Barry Hart. And in the corner to my left, from El Paso, Texas, weighing 333 pounds, here is Black Jack Mulligan.
Unbelievable the size of this man, Mulligan. He is a monster. Here we go.
The following is brought to you by Capital Wrestling Corporation. On Sunday night, May 23rd, there's going to be a benefit card of pro wrestling in West Orange, New Jersey at the South Mountain Arena. And the Unico organization will definitely realize some proceeds from what should be a great night of wrestling. We're going to see on the bill the likes of Mr. Fuji and Mr. Saito, the tag team champions, in addition to a newly formed combination of Tony Atlas and Pedro Morales. Sunday night, May 23rd, 7 p.m. at the South Mountain Arena, West Orange, New Jersey.
We want Andre. You can't help but compare Black Jack Mulligan with Andre the Giant. They are both so big.
Well, so far, no one has been able to stop Mulligan, and it's one man that could probably do it would be Andre. And then again, it could be questionable. You know, Mulligan is a very rough man. He doesn't care about the rules.
Lassie with a kick to the ribs a moment ago. Oh, my.
You know, Vince, I still question the gloves that he wears. As far as I'm concerned, he should not be allowed to wear a glove when he goes into the ring.
Well, we've seen the effect on the cloth. It is not a pretty sight. Not a pretty sight at all. And there's the cloth. Taking no chances, ladies and gentlemen, at all, and what we have seen in the past, because it can't be a mess. When Mulligan applies the claw, when he wants to put it on, nobody can do it like Black Jack Mulligan.
He has not let it go, Vance. He's still holding on.
Gracious, brother, by only my good graces, your humble little body gets to come in the ring with me. Get somebody to bring you to the Madison Square Garden. I don't care how you get there. Get a dump truck, a trash truck. I don't care. Get somebody to bring that defeated body of yours to Madison Square Garden. Climb up in the ring, crawl under, crawl over. And brother, I'm going to tell you something right now. You've got to be the most humiliated, laughed at human being in the history of wrestling. I've got no more time for you, Andre. You get in that ring, brother, and I will finish you off. I will destroy you. Just like I did before. The man was on his knees begging, please, half French, half English, please, Blackjack, quit. I can't take you anymore. I can't, in that muttering voice of yours, I surrender, I can't stand anymore. Right in front of all those thousands of people in Madison Square Garden, you will see Andre for the last time.
Next time you need an oil.
Gentlemen, the next contest, it is a tag team match. Scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Columbus, Ohio, weighing in at 235 pounds, here is Frankie Williams. And his partner, he also hails from Columbus, Ohio, weighing 245 pounds, it is Charlie Fulton. And their opponents, just ready to step into the ring. And here they are, ladies and gentlemen, from Pawhuska, Oklahoma, the sensational Strongbow Brothers. Here is Chief J, weighing in at 147 pounds, and his brother, Jules Strongbow, weighing in at 250 pounds.
A lot of feathers in there, the Strongbow brother. Strongbow is preparing for their matchup here. By the way, you may want to, when you have an opportunity, grab a pencil and some paper, because we're going to be giving you an address to write to for all the organizations that, for the benefit of those of you who were able last year to benefit from the fundraising activities of the World Wrestling Federation. Once again, we're proud to announce that the fundraising committee of the World Wrestling Federation is again offering qualified nonprofit organizations an opportunity to raise money for their respective causes. And at the conclusion of this match, we'll give you an address to write to for more information. But right now, Jules and Jay are ready for action.
The following is brought to you by Capital Wrestling Corporation. On Monday, May 24th, wrestling has the pleasure once again of returning to Poughkeepsie, New York at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center. And you can be sure whenever wrestling is in Poughkeepsie, the greats in the mat game follow, and such should be the case. On the 24th of May, on the bill, the likes of Quick Draw Rick McGraw, Rugged Swede Hansen, and no doubt we will hear Polish power in Poughkeepsie, because on May 24th at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, headlining it all will be none other than the great Ivan Putski.
Unusual maneuver on the part of Jay Strongbow. He can take you down very quickly and take a knee with it.
Very, very true, Vince. He comes up with very unusual moves. You know, earlier I said about the Strongbow brothers, I would doubt if they would be ready for championship matches. I know that Jay, for a fact, is championship material. There's no question about it. But his brother looks very good so far. But when you step in the ring against Fuji and Saito, these two men are well experienced. Great team, so it's not the same thing. But so far, they look very, very good.
Well, I think I differ with you somewhat, Pat, in that bear in mind that for 2 years now, the Strongbow brothers have been together, and granted, mostly European competition and somewhat from the Orient, but they have been a tag team for over 2 years now, so they do have the experience together. Fulton now locking up with Chief J Strongbow. Interesting that J Strongbow discouraged his brother Jules for years, discouraged him from entering the ranks of pro wrestling.
And now they're together in the ring, and I'm sure one of his big dreams would be for him and his brother to become the world's tag team champion. That would be a dream come true for J Strongbow. And Vince, as I said earlier, if they keep going where they're going now, they'll get there. There's no question.
Front face lock, backing Williams up over into the Indian corner.
What's an Indian corner? What is it supposed to look like?
Well, that's a corner surrounded by Indians. Tag made. Whoop. Got half a lick in, partially blocked by Strongbow. Jay Strongbow, that is. And Fulton able to make the tag. Bit of a double team, and Jules backed off by the referee. Double team effort continuing.
Well, I tell you, Jules didn't hesitate to come in the ring and really come and help his brother. You know, Vince, we were talking a couple of weeks ago about brother teams, and there's been a lot of brother teams that have been very, very successful. When you're in the ring with a brother, that's your partner, I mean, it can really depend on. You got the Funk brothers, the Briscoe brothers, the Graham brothers, you can go on and on, the Tolis brothers. so many great teams, brother teams, that really made it to the top.
Jules with Williams catching him coming through the ropes, off the rope, and it chopped there to the throat. To the rope again, and Jules with an elbow. Williams is finding it a little difficult in the ring right now. Jay Squawkball with a sleeper hold. Jules over there making sure there's no interference. Referee allows the entry of Jules, and Frank Williams bites the dust. So another victory for the Strongbow brothers, Jules and Jay. And we'll get the official time.
Here is the time. 4 minutes and 58 seconds, and the winners, the sensational Strongbow brothers, Chief Jay and Jewel.
All right, the Strongbow brothers victorious. I'm sure we'll be seeing a great deal of them in the future. We mentioned earlier on that the fundraising committee of the World Wrestling Federation, again, is active over the years. Certainly all different types of groups, from police benevolent associations to high school classes to almost any worthy organization, has been a part of the hundreds of thousands of dollars that has been generated by sponsoring a World Wrestling Federation, professional wrestling matches in your community. And if your organization would like to obtain information on how the World Wrestling Federation can help you towards your goals, simply send your request on your organization's official stationery to this address, if you may. It's Wrestling Care of the Cape Cod Coliseum, 225 White's Path in South Yarmouth, Massachusetts. Again, we congratulate and are proud of and salute the World Wrestling Federation for their fundraising activity.
And now the president of
Bonnevilleson, the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, an extraordinary athlete, into Madison Square Garden one more time. One more time to face Bob Backlund, the World Wrestling Federation champion, by the date of June 5, that Saturday night. Backlund's ribs should be 100% healed.
Well, Backlund's ribs will be 100% healed, but they were healed before, and it makes no difference. We're not looking for an excuse or an easy way out to beat Bob Backlund. We take it for granted. We know that Bob Backlund is a tough champion, a great champion, but we are thoroughly trained, thoroughly ready, thoroughly prepared. I film all matches in entirety, and Jimmy Snuka has more than proved himself as deserving of the world championship. Bob Backlund struck the referee, I believe, to save his title. This time, there'll be no way out. This time, Bob Backlund, you've got to face Jimmy Snuka. You've got to do it all. The man is in perfect condition, and I'm sure you'll be 100%. So there'll be no excuses when you're beaten in Madison Square Garden and carried out to the streets of New York. You've got to admit that this is your master. This Superfly Jimmy Snuka is your superior, is the greatest.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. But first, the colorful manager. Here he is, the fashion plate of wrestling, Fred Ballatti. And in the corner to my right, from Mount Holly, New Jersey, weighing 226 pounds, here is Paul Figueroa. And in the corner to my left, from Slaughter's Creek, North Carolina, weighing 290 pounds, here is Saweed Hansen.
Sweet Hansen against Paul Figueroa, and Mr. Hansen only has him by, I'd say at least 100 pounds. Here we go.
This is a commercial message. On Tuesday night, May 25th, professional wrestling will return to Freehold, New Jersey at the Freehold Township High School. Mr. Fuji and Mr. Saito will be in individual action that night. Fuji in the main event at the Freehold, New Jersey Township High School, May 25th. And then on May 26th at the Westchester County Center in White Plains, New York, on the bill, the likes of Pedro Morales, Adrian Adonis, Greg Valentine, Tony Atlas, and more. May 26th, a Wednesday, White Plains, New York, at the Westchester County Center.
The big man in there, he is a big, tough individual, this Sweet Hansen.
I would also add ugly.
Well, I think you have a point there, Pat.
Vince, there's no question. He is big and he is powerful.
Figueroa, on the other hand, is no beauty either. Of course, the name of the game is wrestling.
Well, either way you want to put it, he's about Figueroa. If he doesn't, he's no beauty. He won't look good in the ring with Hansen. I promise you that.
Figueroa looks like he's scared to death in there.
Well, Vince, when you really, if you see Hansen in person and you stand next to him, do you really know how big this man is? Big and thick bone.
Hansen has the most unusual colored hair, second only maybe to Jesse the Body Ventura.
Nobody has hair like Jesse the Body Ventura. Well, there's a few up and down the street sometimes.
Not that many. Ventura claims to have a designer hairdo. The first I've ever heard of that. Over the hip, and you see again the big man taunting Figueroa. Look at this. Oh, my. Figueroa is looking for a soft spot in the canvas somewhere. I think maybe one is going to be made here in a moment.
Sort of a backbreaker, but on a kidney area.
Big Sweet with a smile on his face.
It is a time, 2 minutes and 25 seconds, and the winner, Sweet Hansen.
Sweet Hansen, victorious. Next week, we're scheduled to have with us Pedro Morales, the Intercontinental title holder who returns. Scheduled to join us as well, Cowboy Bob Orton. And we shall also have Mr. Fuji, Mr. Saito, the reigning tag team title holders, along with another tag team that's made quite a name for themselves as of late, the so-called Carolina Connection, Steve Travis and Quick Draw Rick McGraw. All of that headed up next week here on Championship Wrestling. No doubt, however, this week, looking exceptionally well, I thought, was Tony Atlas, Superfly Snuka, and what a match we had, Pat, between Gurria and Valentine.
Truly a great match, and I wish I could have seen more of it. I would have loved to see the real end of that match.
Join us next week for more of Championship Wrestling.